Welcome back, fellow scientists. It's Justin again. Today, we're going to dive deep down to the ocean floor where... Mia, what's wrong? Oh, no. Mia's sunglasses fell into the ocean while she was swimming. Okay, don't worry. We were just about to go explore the ocean floor. We can look for your sunglasses along the way. Who doesn't love a deep-sea treasure hunt? By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to describe features of the ocean floor and explain how they're formed. Let's investigate! The ocean floor isn't just flat land sitting quietly at the bottom of the sea. It has towering mountains taller than Everest, trenches deeper than the Grand Canyon, and the largest plains on the entire planet. To have any chance of finding Mia's sunglasses down here, we need to understand what these underwater landscapes look like. Of course, what the ocean floor looks like depends on where you are. Picture a day of swimming at the beach. We know that the ocean can get super deep, but here by the shore, the water is shallow. You might even be able to touch the bottom. This shallow underwater area is called the continental shelf. Along the edges of continents, the ocean floor slopes away from the shore very slowly, creating a wide area where the water stays shallow, like a shelf. Because the water isn't very deep here, sunlight warms it up, making it the perfect place for coral reefs to grow and house lots of vibrant sea life. No sign of Mia's sunglasses, though. This shallow area usually extends 50 miles or more off the shore. What do you think happens when you get to the edge of the continental shelf? At the end of the continental shelf, the ocean floor has a sudden, steep drop-off, like the biggest water slide you've ever seen. This steep drop-off is called the continental slope. Here, the ocean quickly becomes much deeper, and anything that falls off the shelf could slide all the way down towards the deepest parts of the ocean. So, the continental slope is like a slide. What usually happens when you get to the end of a slide? It flattens out. Just like a slide, the continental slope becomes much less steep at the bottom. Sand, mud, and other sediment is deposited here, building up to smoothly connect the steep continental slope to the flat ocean floor below. This flattening out of the drop-off is called the continental rise. Mia's sunglasses could have been deposited along with the sand and mud, but I'm not seeing them yet. Let's keep looking. Beyond the continental rise, we reach the bottom of the ocean. The abyssal plain. This huge flat area stretches for thousands of miles across the deep ocean floor. It's the largest, flattest landscape on Earth, way flatter than any field or playground you've ever visited. The only features breaking up this flatness come from the movement of tectonic plates. Remember how Earth's crust is broken into giant pieces called plates? Depending on how those plates are moving, different features can form. At a divergent boundary, plates slowly move away from each other, which creates a gap in the crust. Magma rises up through the gap into the ocean, where it cools and hardens, forming new crust. This crust builds up to create mountain chains called ocean ridges. These ridges stretch for thousands of miles, winding across the Earth like the seams on a baseball. And Earth's plates don't just move apart. Do you remember what happens when plates move towards each other? At convergent boundaries, one plate can be pushed underneath another. The lower plate sinks deep into the Earth, creating some of the deepest places on our planet. Ocean trenches. Trenches are long, deep underwater valleys. These trenches can stretch hundreds or even thousands of miles along the ocean floor. The Mariana Trench is the deepest ocean trench we know of. It's so deep, we've only been able to explore small parts of it using special submarines and robotic vehicles. If Mia's sunglasses ended up down there, we'd need a lot of equipment to handle the extreme pressure and freezing temperatures, not to mention the total darkness. So let's just hope they didn't sink that far. So the ocean floor has plains, ridges, trenches. What other types of landforms do you think might be hiding beneath the waves? How about mountains? Scattered across the ocean floor are underwater mountains called seamounts. But these aren't just any mountains, they're actually volcanoes that form on the ocean floor. Deep beneath the ocean floor, magma pushes up through weak spots in the Earth's crust, forming volcanoes. What do you think happens when a volcano erupts underwater? The lava cools and hardens, adding new layers each time it erupts. Over time, the volcanic mountain grows taller and taller, becoming a seamount. Most seamounts are underwater, but if they keep erupting and adding more lava, they can grow so tall that their peaks rise above the ocean's surface. When that happens, a seamount becomes a volcanic island. That's how islands like Hawaii were formed. Underwater volcanoes kept growing until they became land you could stand on. But volcanic islands don't last forever. Once eruptions stop, weathering and erosion wear them down. After a long, long time, the island will slip beneath the waves, becoming a seamount once more. And just like how islands sink beneath the waves, let's dive into a review of what we've learned today. As we move from dry land into the ocean floor slowly gets deeper along the continental shelf, then drops sharply down the continental slope and evens out at the continental rise. Most of the ocean floor is the huge, flat, abyssal plain. Tectonic plates shape the ocean floor, forming ridges, trenches, and seamounts, which can grow into volcanic islands. To learn more about the ocean floor, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. We learned so much about the ocean floor today, but I'm sorry we couldn't find your glasses, Mia. What? You found them? Where? You mean to tell me you didn't check your pockets before we explored the whole ocean floor? Turns out the mystery of the ocean floor is no match for the mystery of what's in Mia's pockets. Keep exploring, scientists. There's always more to discover beneath the surface. See you next time! Where are your pockets? You don't wear pants.